Shri Prithvio Namaha, children, you're in Unit 2, Accounts of Not-for-Profit Organization. Now, I'm going to discuss with you problem number 5 today. Right? From the following information, prepare receipts and payments account of Kadalur Kabaddi Association for the following year, 31 March 2019. Right? Now, the opening cash balance they've given you, bank overdraft they've given you, stationery purchase. When you purchase, obviously, you're going to spend money, right? Traveling expenses, dividend received, receipts, dental expenses, you're going, admission fee coming in, courier charges you're paying, municipal taxes paid, again, money is going on payment, interest and bank charges, again, payment, miscellaneous income, money is coming in, upkeep ground. You're going to spend money to keep up the ground, right? So for that, you're going to spend money. Grant from government, receipts coming in, telephone charges you're going to pay, endowment fund receipts, you're going to get it. So receipts, then insurance premium paid, again payment, electricity charges paid, payment, closing cash balance, 1,750. So balance carried down. Right? Now let us start the problem. Okay, so to start, you have to write in the books of whom? In the books of Kadalur Kabaddi Association. In the books of Kadalur Kabaddi Association. For the year 31st March. So in the books of Kadalur Association, okay, what are you preparing? Receipts and payments. Okay. Receipts and payments. In the books of Kadalur Kabaddi Association, receipts and payments. Payments account for the year. Okay, 31st March. Like 31st March 2019. Okay. So let us prepare receipts and payments. Okay. Receipts and payments, you have your details here. So very easy it is, right? We have already done the problem previously. Let me make the thing very small, very big. Okay. Now debit, and then you have credit. Fine. Now opening balance of cash and bank overdraft. Bank overdraft will go to the credit side. Opening balance will come to the debit side. Right? Opening balance 1/4/2018. So how to find out? They've given you 1/4/2018. Right? So 11,000 and 20,000. Okay. Let us start doing the problem. Okay. So to begin with, to balance brought down. Right? How much is this? 14,000. Then that was your opening balance, right? To balance brought down. Okay, that's fine. Okay. So to balance brought down, that is 11,000. Instead of writing 11,000, you know, 14,000. So to balance program, that is cash in hand, right? Cash in hand. Okay. Then next is what your dividend received. So, and you had bank overdraft also. So let us record that first. To bank balance carry brought down. To balance brought down. So you have cash in hand as well as bank overdraft. When you overdraw your account, isn't it? It's called as bank overdraft. The bank will clear your check, okay, so that you don't get embarrassed. And to the extent or the limit to which you have overdraft facility and for which they're going to charge you interest. Fine. So cash in hand, 11,000. Bank overdraft, 20,000. Okay. The next, the dividend. You know, the problem is here. You can call, I have the reader in front of me. And see here, the expenses are mentioned here. And the income and receipts they mentioned. So let us into the problem. First, we'll go one by one. Okay, there are a lot of expenditures and income, so you have to be very careful with the figures. So opening balance here, debit and credit, both the sides we are recorded. Fine, that is over. Next, dividend received. Dividend received. Dividend received is 3,000. Fine. To admission fee. When they admit the children in the cricket academy, they pay admission fee. So admission fee 4,000. That's the only revenue you get, isn't it? Then 2 grand from government. 2 grand from government. Government. So how much is that? 12,000. Okay. Then 2 grand from government, 12,000. Okay. Then next you have to endowment fund receipt. To endowment. Endowment. Fund receipt. Okay. So that is 10,000. Okay. Then to miscellaneous income. 350. Okay, now let us come to payments. So what all you have on the payment side? Buy stationery, purchase. That was 5,200. So the maximum, I'll write one below the other so that it's easy for us to add. Okay, buy traveling expense. So by traveling expenses, you have 1,800. Okay. Then by general expenses. So by general expenses, 500. Okay. Then you have by courier expenses. By courier charges. So by courier charges, 2,000. By municipal tax paid. Okay. The next you have. Okay, what is that next? Go to the problem. By municipal tax paid, by interest on bank charges, by interest on bank charges, charges. Okay, so that is amounting to 250. Fine. Okay, then what is the next one? By upkeep. Upkeep means what? You keep up, clean the ground. By upkeep of ground, 550. So you have to be very careful with the figures. That's the only issue. Okay. While copying, by upkeep. Okay. By telephone charges. Obviously, payment side, you're going to pay 2,800. Depend on your usage, isn't it? So by insurance premium. By insurance premium, 2,000. Okay, then by electricity charges. So that is 5,000. Right. So by balance, your closing balance given also in the problem. By balance carried down, that is your cash in hand, right? By cash in hand. See, it's such a huge problem, no? The whole page is full. 1750. So you should be very careful while you are adding, right? So then that's it. Let us check once again. I'm having the reader with me, so I can always check all the figures are there. Always you check whether all the figures you have copied, okay? So 11,000, yes, 3,000, 4,000, 12,000, 10,000, 350. Because even if there's a small error, then you will not get your closing balance. So 20,000, 5,200, 1,800, yes. General expenses 500, courier expenses 2,000, then municipal tax paid 3,000, 250 is your interest on banks, upkeep 550, 2,800 for telephone, for insurance 2,000, 5,000, and then your closing balance. Closing balance should be 1,750. Now that you have completed it, let us total it. Okay. Now we're going to close this. We need to find out which side is more. I think we'll have which side is more because we have more number of figures, right? So let us total here. Here, zero. Okay, so 27,000. Then 5,500, 5,750. Make it small so it's easy for you to total, that's all. If you're able to total, like, fine, no issues at all. 950, 9,800. 1,750. Okay. Made it small, it's easy for me to add. 515. Right? Carry 1. 14, 15, 20, 28. 30, 35, carry 3. Okay. So 5, 10. So what is the closing balance you are having here? 27,000. Okay. Plus 5,750. Plus 550. 9,800. Write one below the other. Okay. So 0, 5, okay, carry 1, okay, 12, 13, 13, 20, then you have 28, yeah, fine, carry 2, so 10, 20, and then you have 24, carry 2, okay, fine, 44,850. Again, you have to take the balance here. It's quite obvious. They said you have less. Now, let us total here. Here, 11, 14, 18. 18 plus 2, 20, 30, 40,350. Right? 40,350. So, 0,0,5, 4,500. Fine. Again, you check whether we have done it totally properly. 11, 14, 18. 18 plus 2, 20, 30, 40, 40,000. Fine. So we got the balance 4,500. Super. We have completed the problem. To balance, carry down. Okay. So this is going to be your balance. Obviously, bank overdraft because you're going to have a credit balance. Bank overdraft. Right, children? Thank you. Meet you in the next class with another problem.